this lesson, I'm going to show you the steps to get data from a CSV file with thousands of rows. Open the data table in Power Query Editor and then start applying basic table transformations like cleaning our data, reducing rows, deleting columns, sorting, etc. I already opened a blank Excel workbook. Navigate to Data tab and from Get Data button, go into From File and choose the text/CSV option. Let's go and get the CSV file from a folder that I created in my desktop. Copy of data population. Open it and you can see a preview of the table that shows the file origin, how is delimited. Looks on the 200 first rows. Click the down arrow next to load, load 2. And from this dialog box, we are going to import our data. And also check the box add this data to the data model on a new worksheet. Okay, now it's time to open the Power Query Editor. From Data tab, Get Data button and click on Launch Power Query Editor. Here is the query on your left. Click on it and see the data table preview. Power Query Editor, which is made up of four distinct elements. Main ribbon lets you create queries from scratch or edit queries. If you are familiar with the M language, you can also access the advanced editor to tweak them manually. Queries is to keep track of all connections to data sources and streams. Data table preview, to visualize your data result after a specific step. Query settings, applied steps, to navigate through all the steps you made. Power Query automatically records all transformations made. Minimize the navigator pane for now. I don't need all of this data. I only need about 5,000 rows to play with them. So I'm going to show you how to reduce the dataset in order to do some modeling on a smaller dataset. The first thing I'm going to do is to ensure that my headers are appropriate and I don't have headers on the first row. You might notice from the Applied Steps pane that my headers were actually promoted to me. It was one of my first things that happened automatically. If I needed to do that, I will click here, use first row as headers. After that, I look at data types of my columns, beside the names. This is a text, it's good. This is also a text, and these two are numbers. Over that, I have the name of the query, that I will change it to data population. Try to create short and concise table names with no spaces. If you click on All Properties, you can add a description about it. This is my source coming, and by clicking the gear icon, you can see all the details of the CSV file, and you can change something if you like. If I want to get rid of a specific step, I simply click on this little delete icon on the left. To avoid errors by accident, there is a confirmation dialog box. Click Cancel for now. To reduce the dataset, click on Keep Rows button. Let's keep the 5,000 top rows. Okay, if I refresh my query from this button, Refresh All, I will get 5,000 rows. I can also remove columns that I don't need, like the first one for example. Simply click the Remove Columns button and it's gone. Undo this step. If I want to remove duplicates or blank rows, I can do it from here. I can also keep a range of rows, a particular range, from this option, Keep Range of Rows. It's very easy to sort your data, either by clicking one of these buttons, ascending or descending, or by clicking the down arrow of a header and choose specific countries, for example. These are the main tools I can use for reduction or sorting our data set using the Query Editor Home tab. If I like this, I click the Close and Load to button, not Close and Load. We don't want to load this to table into an Excel spreadsheet. I want to only create connection and add this to the data model. On the right of the screen, the Queries and Connection pane opened, showing us all the connections queries we made and information, like how many rows we have loaded and the name of the CSV file, of course. Now look at the Queries and Connection pane. It says 5,000 rows loaded. Highlight this query. My query is now accessible in my data model. Press the Manage Data Model button. And it opens the Power Pivot for Excel. If I want to load the data into my Excel worksheet, click on the three dots, Load to, and import data as a table in the existing worksheet. Okay, and here is my data set. I hope you enjoyed the lesson, and I want to thank you for watching it. Bye! I hope you enjoyed the lesson. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already, so that you can get updates when I put out new videos here. I want to thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video tutorial.